Amen.
Yeah.
Gave me a mind to be saved. Amen. I was so tired of myself. Anybody here sick and tired of yourself?
Yeah.
Remember how sick and tired you got of yourself?
Yeah.
Pastor said he even thought it's got to be something better than this.
That's right.
And it is something better than that.
Yeah.
It's something better than what we're going through right now. We have eternal life abiding in our souls. Amen.
Yeah.
And if we keep on holding on unto the hand of the Lord,
yes,
that eternal life will get you out of here one day. Amen.
Yeah.
They sing a song now, I cried my last tear. No, you haven't. You ain't cried that last tear till you leave this earth.
Yeah.
Till your feet leave this earth, amen.
Hallelujah.
But she said, I cried my last tear yesterday. I said, no, you haven't, honey. You're going to cry a lot of more tears, amen,
yeah,
before you leave this earth.
Yeah.
And know that your God sees every tear. Chapman, why do I want to? You look like a Mitchell to me. I don't know why. But welcome Deacon Chapman back. He's been a pretty much a regular visitor, amen?
Amen.
We're going to miss you when your church opens back up, amen? And we'd also like to welcome Brother David and his wife today. It's always a treat to have them here, amen? Amen. I think it's a beautiful thing when a husband and wife can praise God together, amen? That was just beautiful. We thank you guys for that, amen? Amen. Right now, we're going to ask you to feel if you would come forward and lift our afternoon's offering, amen? Amen. How many know it's a blessing to give? God can only bless that when you give, amen? Amen. You know, if you work hard all week, you go on Friday, you want that boss man to hand you your check, don't you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's just like God. He said, give him 10%. That's all. 10% of all your increase. Amen. And he said, give a love offering. Give an offering. Amen.
Amen.
He said, will a man rob God? He said, yes, but you robbed me in tithes and offerings. Amen. But I know we don't have any thieves in here, do we? No. No. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. So we're going to ask everyone to stand, please. Father, we come before you in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, asking that you'll bless this offering, Lord. Build up your kingdom with it, Lord Jesus. We ask you, Lord, that you'll touch hearts and touch minds. If they don't give, Lord, bless them, Lord, that they have to give. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask you, Lord, that you'll bless Christian ministries, Lord, and help us, Lord, to bring souls into your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.
That's when we come from the center out.
Come from the center out, Pastor Pete. Meet in the center and we'll come.
Strength. He is our strong tower.
Yes.
He He is a very present help. So let us just give the Lord one more praise in this atmosphere. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. For you are good and your mercy endured forever. And we certainly do want to honor our First Lady, Lady Tracy Quinn, on today. We thank God for her. We praise God for her. Happy Valentine's Day. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We certainly do praise God for her. We praise God for Pastor Duck. Amen. Taking charge of the service, leading the service, amen. Being a help. Hallelujah. We thank God for helps. We certainly do praise God for Mother Louise Davis. Amen. Praise God for her. Praise God for Minister Grady and Daniels and Deacon Fields. Praise God for my brother being here on today. Minister Sylvester Quinn. Praise God for her. We certainly do praise God for all of our members of Christian Ministries at the Apostolic Church. Thank God for the virtual church. The people that are tuning in with us online, we thank God for Brother David. Brother David, what's your wife's name? Emeris.
Yes.
We thank God for her as well. Amen. And I don't have to say it, but I'm going to say it just to be public. You always welcome.
Amen.
Amen. You always know that. You always know that. Thank you, Lord. And it's a joy and a delight when you come in.
Yeah.
Amen. And we certainly do thank God from Deacon Chapman. Amen.
Amen.
We praise God for you and our ushers. Amen. We praise God for you all as well.
Amen.
Amen. And you know, when we're looking at the Word of God and the scriptures in the Word of God, it's certainly an honor to stand before you. And we don't take this mission lightly. Because we know that, I can say it two ways. You want to hear from God, and I want to hear from Him too. So we certainly praise God, and we solicit your prayers on today. Amen. Truly, God is our strength and our shield. Amen. And we certainly do praise God for, oftentimes people don't say this enough, but you ought to thank God for your tests and your trials.
Amen.
And the things that you're going through. Even now, whatever you're going through, you ought to praise God for. Can we just praise God for whatever it is? Give Him a nevertheless praise. Give Him a nevertheless praise. It's nevertheless praise. Hallelujah. 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 It doesn't matter the trial. It doesn't matter the temptation. But nevertheless, I will praise you. Nevertheless, I will bless your name. Nevertheless, I will see your glory. Nevertheless, there will be an after this praise, and after this worship. Hallelujah. We got to praise God by faith. We walk by faith and not by sight. Hallelujah. We certainly do praise Him. I want you to stand with me on today. Thank you, Jesus. And as we begin to look at the word of the Lord, we want you to turn with me to the book of Galatians. The book of Galatians, chapter number 4. Thank you, Lord. The good book of Galatians, chapter number 4. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. If you have a say, man, I feel like shouting John, just hold my mule, I shout right now. Give God a nevertheless, nevertheless praise. Pray. Amen. Galatians chapter number 4 and verse 19, just one verse of scripture there. And it says, my little children, of whom I travail in birth again, until Christ be formed in you. Can we read that together? My little children, of whom I travail in birth again, until Christ be formed in you. And just one more time. My little children, of whom I travail in birth again, until Christ And since we failed that time, let us do it one more time, all together. My little children, of whom I travail in birth again, until Christ be formed in you. Oh, gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we certainly do thank you, Lord, for this word on today. We thank you for the anointing that you have placed in this place. Lord, we bind every evil spirit, every demonic power that would come to hinder in the name of Jesus. All of our confidence and all of our trust is in you. And Lord, we pray that you have your way. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And I just want to take a thought from today, till Christ be formed in you. Christ be formed in you. And we're taking that particular scripture from the book of Galatians, chapter number 4 and verse 19. And Galatians is a very interesting book because Paul is really airing some of his concerns with the people of God. They literally had believed in Christ and trusted in the Lord. And some things have gone awry. Some things have seemed to be misstepped, misplaced. And he saw some changes in their walk with God. So Paul wrote this particular epistle to get things back on track. How many of you know that God is concerned about your spiritual life? And he will send you a word to get your life back on track.
Yes, yes.
Amen. The word of God, the word of God is quick and it's powerful.
Yes.
Amen. And it's able to be a discerner of your thoughts and intents of your heart.
Yes.
To get your life back on track.
Amen.
So Paul was concerned about the Galatians because they were turning back. They were literally backsliding. Their lives were being turned back, and they were going back to their old ways. You can tell if your life has been affected or there's some major changes when you start doing the things you used to do. When you start thinking about the things that you used to do, that's when you know that you're in trouble. And you're in dynamic trouble when you start not only thinking about it, but doing the things that you used to do. You know that you have slipped from this place called grace. You have gone backward in your walk with God. That's why the Bible tells us we ought to call back the former days when we were first illuminated. When you think about when you were first in touch with Jesus, how your life was changed and you couldn't get enough of the Lord. You couldn't get enough of praising him and worshiping. When you woke up in the morning, you had him on your mind. When you went to bed at night, he was the last person you talked to. Amen. And you did good all day. You watched what you said. You watched what you put on. You watched everything that you ate. If you were fasting, you fasted consistently. You did those things that were consistent unto the Lord. You magnified him every chance you got. But sometimes in our walk with God, the enemy can creep in unawares and slip in, and then we'll find ourselves not fasting and praying as often. You can find yourself not reading the word as often as you do. Even when you came into the church, you first sat up front, and then you start sitting in the middle, and then you start sitting in the back, and then you find yourself not even attending the whole service. Find some excuses to leave. And that's when you know that something's going wrong. That's when you know that something is happening that needs to be changed. The Bible says, let a man examine himself to see whether he's in the faith. We ought to take a daily inventory of our lives. We ought to take a daily inventory. Lord, did I magnify you today? Did I do what you told me to do? Did I lift up and did I give you glory? Was I walking obedient unto the vocation wherewith I've been called? We ought to examine ourselves. The Bible tells us to examine ourselves. Not let God examine us, but we ought to examine ourselves. Not let the pastor examine us, but we ought to examine ourselves. For what? To see whether or not we're walking in the faith. It's important for us to walk in the faith. It's important for us to hold up the bloodstained banner. It's important for us to walk worthy of this vocation wherewith we've been called. You know, a lot of people take their Christian walk as a I don't know what the right word would be, but a lot of people take their Christian walk as being non-serious. But you've got to be serious with your walk with God. You've got to be serious in your attitude with God. Even in the New Testament, God was slaying folk in the New Testament. Remember Ananias and his wife, when they lied to the Holy Ghost? The Bible said that they fell down dead. Amen. Because they lied to the Holy Ghost. God was letting them know that I'm serious about this walk. We've got to be serious about our walk with the Lord. The Bible tells us that we've got an adversary, the devil. All he wants to do is kill, steal, and to destroy us. But Jesus, he gave his life. He gave his life for you and I. So we ought to be serious about this walk, and we ought to give our lives unto the Lord. So Paul, he was concerned about them, and as he was concerned that he saw some things that they were doing, and that they were allowing others to influence them. He was concerned about being confused or being affected by negative people. You know, you gotta watch out who you hang around with. There's always a root cause to every problem. Amen. And if you're not the problem, then who you're hanging around with, they could be the problem. They could be the ones that is affecting your atmosphere. I don't know about you, but I've been high in the Lord, and my mind stayed on Jesus, and I get around some people that are Debbie Downers and negative folk, and they try to affect the anointing that is in my life. They try to affect the joy that Jesus gave unto me. My God, have you ever been around people that flipped your mood, that turned you around? You high in the Lord, you're praising and you're worshiping Him, and you get around people that you listen to, and they kind of affect your mood. They talk about negativity. They talk about things that they ought not talk about. Those are the ones you got to watch out for. Those are the ones you got to keep your eye on that are trying to affect you and to bring you down. The Bible says that evil communication, it corrupts good manners. And you got to be careful and not allow people to invade your mind space. The Bible says, guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it comes the issues of life. You gotta guard your heart. You gotta guard your mind, and not allow negativity to fester in your mind. And you know, when you surround those negative folk and they drop their load on you, and then they go their merry way, you there thinking about what they say. You there thinking about the turmoil or suffering the effect of what they brought into your life. And then you got to find yourself trying to bring every thought back into captivity to the obedience of Christ. My God, I see why Jesus said you got to allow, he will keep you in perfect peace if your mind is stayed on Him. I see why Jesus told us that if you want to be peaceful, you got to keep your mind stayed on the Lord. And the book of Philippians, it tells us that we ought to think on these things. Whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are honest. And if there be any good report, if there be any praise in it, you've got to think on these things. Don't allow your mind to go rampant. Don't allow your mind to go to pitter and post. Don't allow your mind to enter into things that you know they ought not be. Some things are too high for us. Hallelujah. Some things are too wide for us. Some things are too broad for us. That's why the Bible said, let God be true. Oh, my God, and every man be a liar. My God, and so Paul, he was concerned about this particular church, and as any good leader and as any good pastor, pastor and as any good friend and any good saint of God, you ought to be concerned about the people, my God, that God has placed you with. You ought to be concerned about the people that are around you. And that's what Paul was concerned, because he was noticing their lifestyle was changing and he was concerned about them. And Paul had labored with them. He had given them the gospel of Jesus Christ, which is the power of God unto salvation. Paul was there when some of them tarried for the Holy Ghost and was filled with that anointing, and they were walking in their assignments and they were living out the things that God has called them to do. My God, and then when they saw an abrupt change in their life, he said, "Oh, foolish Galatians, who have bewitched you, that you should believe not the truth, that you should believe a lie." Notice that when things happen and people start to change, it's a devil that is trying to influence their lives. It's an enemy that is trying to creep in unawares and to affluence you. I see why the Bible says, and it tells us to put on the whole armor of God, that we might be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Now, God, you've got to guard your heart with all diligence. You've got to fight the good fight of faith. You've got to realize that I'm in a fight and I'm in it to win it. I'm in it to win it. I've got to pull down every stronghold that is trying to keep me down. I've got to bring down every negative thought. Hallelujah, because the enemy will come and tell you that you're no good. The enemy will come and tell you that you can't make it. But you've got to realize, as Paul was reminding them, that they were bought with a price and they are not their own. You've got to remind yourself that, and like David did, he encouraged himself. You've got to encourage yourself in the Lord and realize that God is with you. And if God be with you, who then can be against you? You've got to lift up your head, all you gates, and be lifted up the everlasting doors and allow the King of Glory, my God, to come in. You gotta go and fall on your knees and sing after God until you get an awakening in your spirit, until God shows up, until the anointing shows up, until the power of God shows up, until the angels show up. Hallelujah, to rebuke the hand of the enemy. You've got to come boldly, the Bible says, unto the throne of grace. Hallelujah. Don't forsake your help. Don't forsake your help. Don't forsake your help. Don't forsake your help. You can be in the midnight hour. Hallelujah. And call on the name of the Lord. And the battle doesn't belong to you, but the battle belongs to the Lord. You've got to remind yourself that Jesus is your master, that Jesus is your savior, that you've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. You've got to remember, my God, that's what Paul was reminding them, that you were once darkness, that you were once aliens, that you were once foreigners and strangers from the covenant of Israel, but now are you the sons of God, now are you the children of God, my God, and now you've got to walk worthy of that vocation where God has called you. Don't allow the enemy to tell you that you're no good. Don't allow the enemy to tell you that God doesn't care about you. My God, you've got to realize that if God didn't care, why did he send Jesus to help me? If God doesn't care, why did he not give me the grace? Why did he not give me the power of the Holy Ghost? If God didn't care, he wouldn't have sent his word. He wouldn't have sent his word to anoint you. If God didn't care, he wouldn't have visited you. Tell your neighbor that God cares.
you got to know that God is faithful when he brings you out of your test. Come on and give God a praise. Give God a praise. My God, give God a praise. Give God a praise for his faithfulness. Give God a praise because he's your rock. He's your salvation. Give God a praise because he's your strength. Give God a praise. You don't understand it, but he's a very present help in your time of trouble. Though the enemy will try to slay you, yet will I trust you. Yet will I believe in you. Yet will I magnify you. Yet will I give you glory. Come on and give God glory. Open up your hands and praise you the Lord. Just do a little dance and praise you the Lord. Just wave your hand and praise you the Lord. The atmosphere changes. Praise you the Lord. Oh God, come on and give him one more praise. Come on and magnify him. Oh God, I thank you. I thank you. Hallelujah. I believe just thank him today. Thank you, Lord. Oh, that we be seated in the presence of the Lord. You see, Paul, he was concerned about the people, and he was wondering or not his labor was in vain. Oh, God, when you're dealing with people, especially people that you want to see do well, especially people that you want to see do great things. Oh, my God, I can see Paul now. He saw that the potential that's in the people to do great exploits for God. Sometimes when I look at you all, I see great exploits that you can do for the Lord. I see some greatness in you. I see God in you. I see the anointing upon you. I see the power of God resting on you. And when God sends you tests and trials, sometimes he lets me know that I'm building them up, Pastor. I'm strengthening them in their spirits because I want them to be strong. I don't want them to depend on themselves. I want them to depend on me. Jehovah Jireh, Elohim. I want them to depend on me. Emmanuel. I want them to depend on me. The way maker, the mountain mover, the strong tower. But sometimes they have rocks and stumbling blocks in their way. And I have to show them who I am. Oh God, that's why you gotta pray for your tests. That's why you gotta pray for your trials. Because God is trying to show you who he is. That he is the Elohim. That he is the Jehovah Rapha. That he is the one that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you're able to ask or think. And when God gets done with you, now all you can say is my soul looks back and wonder how I got over. Hold up your hands. Hold up your hands. My soul looks back and wonder how I got over. How I got over this. Because God was with me. How did I make it through that? Because God was with me. Oh, give God a praise. Give God a praise. God wants to be with you. Say, I'm with you. I'm with you. You got to know that God is with you. No matter how dark the day, God is with you. If I want to turn off all the lights and all you can see is blackness, God is still there. God is still there, and he's still there with all of his power. He's still there with all of his anointing. He's still there with all of his glory. You got to give God a praise. Oh God, he's still there. Tell somebody he's still there. When the enemy comes up against me like a flood, he's still there. When the devil knocks at my door, he's still there. When
when trials and tribulation are coming, he's still there. He's still God. He's still our strength. He's still our refuge. He's still our fortress. He's never changing. He's still there.
Until you get
confession that God is my strength, that God is my shield, and I can live holy because God is holy. You won't think it strange. You won't think it weird that you're living above the evil that is presented unto you. Let me stop right there just for a moment. A lot of us, if we're honest, sometimes we don't think that we can live this thing. The Bible says that you were made in the image and in the likeness of God. That's what Jesus was saying. The Bible in Philippians was saying that he being in the saw himself in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. Amen. You've got to realize you were made in the image and the likeness of God. Amen. And God has given you his spirit. So therefore, he's given you a command to be holy like he's holy. And so you've got to think it not robbery. Hallelujah. That you can be just like him. That you can live holy. That you can live righteous. That you can live above sin. Hallelujah. And it's just a life thing. Hallelujah. When you realize that if you walk in the Spirit, if you walk in God's anointing, you will fulfill the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life. If you walk in God's Spirit, there's no way for you to backslide. There's no way for you to turn around, because you'll always humble yourself beneath the mighty hand of God, and God will always exalt you, because God is faithful. That's why the Bible says, resist the devil and he shall flee. You gotta resist the devil, resist the enemy. Allow God to be God in your life, that Christ be formed in you.
How's he formed in you? How's he formed in you? When you walk in his obedience, he's being formed in you. When you do the things that God has commanded you to say, against all odds, he's being formed in you. When you praise God in the middle of it, he's being formed in you. When you thank God, hallelujah, amidst every test and every trial, he's being formed in you. When you study his word, God's word, hallelujah, is his thoughts. And when you allow God's thoughts to be in your mind, he's being formed in you. That's why the Bible says, there is therefore now no condemnation. Hallelujah. You can't be condemned. There's no condemnation to them that are well in Christ Jesus. Who walk not after the flesh. That's what they were doing in Galatia. And I don't say Galatianville. They were walking after the flesh. Hallelujah. What are you doing in your field? Where you live? Are you walking after the flesh, or are you walking after the Spirit? If you walk after the flesh, all it's going to bring you is death and condemnation. But if you walk after the Spirit, it's going to bring you life, and that more abundant. That's what Paul was saying. Sometimes situations happen. Amen. Sometimes people get distracted. All right? But don't allow, I want y'all to hear me. Don't allow the devil to overtake you to where you lose out on your God. What profit is a man that he gain the whole world and lose his soul? And what will a man give in exchange for his soul? Is it worth it? Next time you come upon a person that's walking slow-footed and not needed, is it worth it? Hey! See now, y'all do that if y'all got the Holy Ghost abiding with you. Because you don't want to get a punch in the head. But that's it, is it worth it? Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
mind of Christ. Get the spirit of Christ. Let Christ dwell in your heart by faith, so that you can overcome every trial, every temptation. Most of all, in this sermon today, so you don't backslide. Amen.
Amen.
Backsliding, not an option.
No.
Huh? Backsliding, not an option.
No.
How many of you got your mind made up?
Amen.
And your heart is fixed?
Yes.
Yeah.
Amen.
No time. Some of us are too far out there.
Yes.
Hey, hallelujah. To turn back now. Every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. Mind made up, heart fixed, looking to the hills from which cometh my help, and know that all my help cometh from the Lord. Come on, give God a praise. Don't let the labor of Jesus Christ be in vain. Don't let the labor of the Father be in vain. Don't let the labor of the Holy Ghost be in vain. Let the church stand. Working out some plans to get my pool and find a place for it. Hallelujah. It looks like I'm going to have to build me a spot. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So we're going to pray. Pray that if anything, I must have an internal clock on me. And we're at 12:30. Amen. Ain't that good? Oh, hallelujah. Let us. Ah, hallelujah. God said, I'm your clock. Hey, I woke you up this morning. I started you on. Gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this word on today. Lord, we travail until Christ be formed in us. Lord, we ask you to establish us, that you lead us to that rock, that you lead us to that anointing, that you destroy every yoke, put down every stronghold in the name of Jesus. And Lord, those that are under the sound of our voice and they need salvation, Lord, we ask you to lead them to repentance, and you bless us, Lord, to set up our pool, hallelujah, so that we can baptize them in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you and we praise you for the fellowship. We thank you and praise you for the anointing. We thank you and praise you for the glory. And the honor, equitable shot. In Jesus' name, our feet was almost about to slip, but God. But we almost went the wrong way, but God. We almost died, but God. Equitable shot, equitable shot. Lord, continue to show forth your glory. Continue to show forth your power. Continue to show forth your anointing. Bless us, Lord, with all provision. This we pray in Jesus' name. Bring us back at the appointed time. Amen and amen.
Amen.
One Lord.